Hello guys, welcome back to our channel Civil Engineering Education. Today I am back with another topic to the continuation of previous one on reinforcements. So in this video we are going to discuss about different shapes of rebars and also clear covers we provide to the concrete members. So in previous videos we also covered what is reinforcement, types of reinforcements, grades of reinforcements, dias of bars and how to find out the weight of steel bar per meter length and feet length. Also we covered methods of estimation of steel like from drawings and also on percentage basis. So if you haven't watched that videos, I'll provide the links in description. You can watch that videos before watching this video. So if you like this video, hit the like button, and if you are new to the channel, do subscribe. So in general, in quantity surveying, we come across bar bending schedules. So in bar bending schedule, our task is to find out the length of different shapes bars. So here, these are the different shaped bars which we come across in different elements. So first one is straight bar, which we can see in slabs. This is nothing but distribution bar. So distribution bar is provided in straight. Second type of bar is bar with hooks. So this kind of bars are provided in footings and also beams. So these bars we generally see in olden days, but nowadays we are providing straight bars. Coming to third one, this is the cranked bar. So this cranked bars we can see in beams and also slabs. Next type is a ring. So this kind of rings we provide in beams and also columns. So if we provide this in beam, we call it as a stirrup. If we provide this in column, we call it as a lateral tie. So next one is cranked bar with hooks. So same bar, but it is provided with hooks. Next one is cranked bar, which is provided only in one side. So crank is provided only in one side. Next one is this 90 degree bend bar. It's like a U-shaped bar, which we come across in footings as well as beams. Next one is L-shaped bar. So L-shaped bar is provided in footings and columns. So mainly in case of footing column junction, so the column bar will be connecting like this. So mainly we provide this kind of bar in footings for raising the column. Next type of bar is this shape of bar is used for staircase purpose. So these are the different shapes of bars which we come across in our calculations. And also one more type, that is nothing but a chair. So this is nothing but a chair which we provide when the two layers of reinforcements are distant from each other. So coming to the clear covers. So what is a clear cover? Clear cover is nothing but this is the gap which is provided between the concrete face and also reinforcement face. This gap is to provide the safety to the reinforcement, which can be saved from environmental conditions. So if you take a beam, so this is the beam outline, you can see this is the concrete face of beam and this is the stirrup we provide. So this gap, the gap which we provided between these two, is called as a clear cover. So this is an example. So for different elements we are going to provide different clear covers. For footings we provide 50 mm gap, that is clear cover. For columns 40 mm, beams 25, slabs 20 mm or 15 mm, in case of staircase 20 mm, in case of pedestal 40 mm. So these are the clear covers which we provide for different elements. Note that nominal cover should not be less than dia of bar. So if we are taking the dia of bar as 16 mm, the minimum cover should be more than 16 mm. So coming to next, common types of rebars which we use in construction. So these are nothing but grades of steel which we provide in reinforced concrete structures. So plain bars, in olden days we used to use this kind of plain bars, that is Fe250 grade of steel, but in nowadays we are using HYSD bars, high yield strength deformed bars. So these bars will be consisting of ribs which will provide proper bonding in concrete, and also it will be having proper strength. So HYSD bars like Fe415, Fe500 and Fe550 550 are used in construction depending upon the project. So now coming to lapping length. What is lapping length? So in general, we provide lapping in reinforcement because the length of bar will be 12 meters. So this is the standard length of bar. The length of bar is 12 meters or 40 feet. Right. So after this length, what we have to do? Again, we need to overlap the bar and we can continue the bar. So here you can see the lap. So this is one bar and this is another bar. We have lapped here. So for lapping, there are different conditions as per IS codes. We are going to see that in the coming videos. So stay tuned for coming videos. Don't miss my videos. So if you watch the continuation, then you will be understanding. If you miss the video in between, so you can't understand anything. If you are watching this channel for the first time, do subscribe and hit the like button if you like. Thanks for watching.